before we can send the instructions that we've put into our computer and down into our robot pet, we need to connect the two. We have a special cable to do this. This cable, you notice, has a flat end at one end, and the other end, a rather more squarish one, with a couple of slightly chamfered, slightly corners cut at an angle. Now, if we look on the side of our computer, you'll see there's a variety of different shapes of plugs that we can put in. Now, it turns out that the flat ones, what we call a USB port, are these ones here. Now, you'll notice this one has slightly slanting corners. That's not the right one. The USB are completely right angle corners. So we'll try putting that in. Oh, we got it first time. If you put it in upside down, it won't work, and you have to take it out and put it down again. It's unusual for me to get it right the first time. Now, we look at the other end, and if we look at our robot pet, there's four on this side. This is where we attach other sensors later on, light sensors and things like that. But we don't connect that end. If we look at the other end, where we've got ABC for our motors, notice we've got USB here. That's where we connect it. Now, you notice there are slight corners there. It only goes in one way round. And if we take a careful look at that, we'll see that there are just little slanting bits on the top, and the slanting bits on the top of this fit in that way. So we connect the two, plug them in, and we're fixed. And so we've now got a robot pet connected up by cable, by USB cable, to our computer, ready to send our set of instructions from our computer down into our robot pet, where they'll be hopefully obeyed.